Hello. It is Monday, April 13th, and it is well past time for some more Doom. I haven't played this game in 5 days, so I'm sure that this will go swimmingly. Well, we're not immediately being attacked as soon as we start the level, which is a step up from previous levels. In this episode, I don't remember much about this level. I remember spending some time on it, failing a couple times, but that's okay. Failing is how you learn. Remember that. Be mindful that every failure is a necessary step towards success. And you'll do just fine. Or you'll decide it's not worth it, and you'll find something else to fail at. Something where failing feels good. I just spent a pretty good bit of time failing at Contra. And I'm okay with that, because I did better at Contra than I ever had before. And it felt pretty good. Even if I did die at the last boss, still way better than I thought I would do. And, you know, I'm sure that I will get there. I will meet my goal of clearing Contra for the NES in one credit, and then I'll be able to say that I did it. Which, how many people can say that, you know? I think a lot more people could clear Contra in one credit if they wanted to, if that appealed to them. If they actually gave it a shot, they'd probably find that the game isn't as hard as people made it out to be. It's hard, but not in a way that the challenge can't be overcome. It can be learned if you want to learn it. As can Doom. Even episode 4, it can be learned. Learning might be a frustrating experience, but if it was so frustrating that I wasn't getting any pleasure out of doing it, any value, then I would stop and do something else. That's the thing about video games. There are a million of them. Many of them available for free. And if something's not clicking with you, play another one. That has been my philosophy for a long time. Okay, who just shot at me? There you are. Alright, I seem to remember wanting to go left. But I want to clear out these specters first. Because if I get bottlenecked in the lava corridor, that would be a lot of unnecessary damage. I don't remember how many specters there were. I thought maybe If there were more, I might be able to draw them out. Right, so I go this direction. I can grab the radiation suit. I don't have to deal with the shotgun guy immediately. Although, I don't want to dawdle. The shotgun guys are kind of the primary threat on this level. At least until the Barons of Hell reveal themselves. The imps are also a threat, but they're a threat that's easier to mitigate. Alright. I probably let too much of this radiation suit go to waste by being a little too cautious in this section. What I hate about damage floors is that, you know, in my view, they discourage good play. Like, they discourage being careful. They discourage taking your time, thinking things out, being patient. They make it impossible to be patient because you're taking damage. And that's why they're probably my least favorite design element in Doom. And when I'm playing solo, or not for an audience, I will often just god mode my way through the lava floors and the acid floors, and then turn god mode off when I'm back to safety. Because honestly, it just sucks not being able to actually look around because you're taking damage. Luckily, that hasn't been too much of a thing in the original Doom, but it definitely becomes more of a thing in the later games, by which I mean Doom 2 and Final Doom, mostly. Not as much of a thing in Doom 64, surprisingly, which is one of the things I liked a lot about Doom 64. It might be my favorite official Doom release besides the original Doom. I might like it more than Doom 2. I don't know, I'd have to play through Doom 2 again. It's been a minute. So this Baron of Hell isn't even active, or it's active, but it's not even released yet. So I need to figure out which side of the teleporter corresponds to where, and maybe mark it on the map somehow. Of course, the mark will go away if I load a save, so I would have to remember it in the long run, but just in the short term. I'm letting a lot of this radiation suit go to waste, but I feel like it's worth it if I can mitigate these threats before they become more of a threat. I have a lot of rockets. I probably should have been using them. That was pretty scary. I need to get in there. I need to get that health, and I need to get that key. Because with my autosave setup, getting that key means... Oh. It just opens when I press that button? That's weird. I feel like that Baron of Hell... I don't remember manually releasing that Baron of Hell. Okay, those fireballs are definitely coming from outside. When I was stepping up there. Oh, I was kind of hoping there would be... Okay, there's a cockademon out there, that's why. Whoa, whoa! I can just walk through those bars? What the C? What the H-ing C? That is total BH. That is some grade A bull honky. I mean, it's kind of cool. But still. Seem to be some good rewards down here as well. Alright. I'm pleased that I discovered that. I'm gonna make this level a lot easier. Well, maybe. There's still a lot of stuff I have to worry about. Okay, so it did save. Wanted to make sure I actually picked up that key and it didn't teleport or something. Alright, I lost a lot of health there, but I have a save now, so it's okay. Alright, when I step onto the teleporter from the west, it teleports me here. Which I don't think I've done before. Okay, yeah, I have done that because I remember this. Okay, so I have another save now. Is this a... Oh. Well, crap. Alright, let's step onto the teleporter from the south. I'm assuming I'm correct and it's directional based and not some sort of random... BS. Okay, so south takes me to the rockets. Okay, so it looks like stepping on it from a direction kind of teleports you in that direction. So if that's true, that'll be good. Yeah, I stepped on it from the east and it teleported me east-ish. Okay, a lot of this stuff is open now. Interesting. There's a lot of stuff out there. Is that teleporter the exit? I mean, it doesn't matter if it is because I'm not even close to getting the master key yet. Which is troubling. But it would be good to know for later. It's not the exit. I telefrag something. Alright, so this is the save right after I get the blue key. I guess there's nothing in my rules that say I can't roll back to a previous save if I want to, which I might end up wanting to. Alright. Yeah, step on it from the south teleports me south. Okay. Alright, I'm just going to let this kill me for now, because I don't actually need to get those rockets. At this stage, that's just unnecessary damage. So I want to go north, right? Well, I should probably... Should I go east first? Maybe. Let's try going east. I mean, that's the direction that the arrow is. So let's see if there's anything that I missed up here. Okay. So it's looking like the arrow is sort of out in this... Well, no. It's in the direction of this Kako Demon. I should definitely kill this stuff before I anger any of the stuff out in the amphitheater. That's what I'm calling the area outside of these colored gates. Oh, that is some dirty tricks, Doom. Come on. Teleporter in the middle of the dang sky. Alright, want to take out any threats out here before I step in that teleporter. Or as many as I can. Some stuff out here I can't see. Oh, the imp. I think that's the one that I telefragged. Ah, crud. There's a Berserk pack over there. So that'll get me back up to 100. That'll be really nice. And a BFG. Do I have the BFG yet? Well, I wouldn't be able to switch to it even if I did, because I don't have enough ammo. And with my current setup, it only shows weapons that I have ammo for. Or I can only switch to it if I had enough ammo to shoot it, although, or to fire it. But that is an option in GZ Doom. You can change. Okay, Baron of Hell. That's fair. Totally normal for a Baron of Hell to be out here. And that's, you know, not sarcasm. There's the arrow. Oh, the Baron of Hell. Okay. Well, hi. Thanks for the warm welcome. Gotta be a little careful running around with my rocket launcher out like this. But I'm fully expecting these kind of surprises, so as long as I can back up and give myself enough leeway, I'll be fine. Okay. Should switch back out before I step into this teleporter now. Okay, well, that unleashed the Keymaster. Did also... Oh, there's a teleporter here. Okay. Which means the arrow is probably over here somewhere. Most inconvenient setup possible, really. Make me do most of the level before I can grab the arrow. Although it is convenient that there's a key there, because it means I get a save right after I find the arrow. I hear doors opening. Or maybe a crusher somewhere got activated. Oh, this whole middle section is raising out. That's cool. Thanks for the key. Oh! A cyber demon. Well, that's not fair. I have a save right before the cyber demon, so I might just try to run for it, because I won't have to... Oh, are they infighting? Oh, yes. Distract that cyber demon, Kako. Thank you. Greatly appreciated, friend. Okay, well, that wasn't the right way to handle that situation. Was this thing not activating, or was I not activating it right? Was I hitting it, like, at an angle? I don't think they would disable that elevator thing. Boy, I know random numbers don't work this way, but that cyber demon was incredibly close to being the Keymaster, and I'm glad it wasn't. That would be a pain in my ass. Alright, run across here. Alright, what has opened that I didn't have access to before? Probably the path with the cyber demon, right? I'm probably going to have to go that way. Let's see if I can slip past it. Ah, crud. Oh, okay. I must have been hitting this thing wrong. Okay, so the cyber demon is to the south. So what happens if I just teleport to the south? Would it place me directly in front of the cyber demon, or would I be able to slip behind it that way? I mean, I could kill it, but it would just involve me... Oh, the imp didn't die. That's not fair. Like, killing the cyber demon would just involve pumping all of my ammo into it, and it would take several minutes, and it's just... I'd rather not if I didn't have to, you know? Come on, buddy. How did you even survive a rocket blast that was strong enough to knock you into the lava? Well, I guess you are the Keymaster. Okay, that's fair. Of course, having quad damage would make killing the Cyber Demon a lot faster. So, if it comes to it, that wouldn't be that big of a deal. Alright, let's see what happens if I try to teleport past it. If that's even remotely possible. No, because it's going to place me here, right. Okay, so yeah, there are like metal bars there. So, it's going to make me kill the Cyber Demon before I can exit the level. There's no getting past that. I've accepted that fact, and I am prepared to make the sacrifice. I mean, it's not much of a sacrifice, it's just a little bit of time spent. A little bit of annoyance. Boy, those rockets move fast. Damn it. This imp is not cooperating. It's probably a better idea to fight the Cyber Demon from across the chasm. Because the Cyber Demon doesn't have much room to move around. So, dodging my shots is going to be tricky for it. And it'll make it a lot easier for me to dodge its shots. Right, 3 rockets. That's how many Cyber Demon shoots at a time. 3, not 2. Okay. You think, oh, well, thank you. You think I would know a thing or two about Cyber Demons by now. But, apparently not. I don't know, I feel like it does shoot 2 rockets sometimes. But 3 is kind of the standard amount. You know, it's not like the Holy Hand Grenade. It doesn't have to be exactly 3 every time. You can fudge it a little bit. But 3 is definitely the recommended. See? That time it was 2. Or maybe it was 3 and one of rockets got caught up on the pillar. Got it. Nice. Did anything else step out? Because it would be very like this game to give you some other kind of nightmare horror to deal with after you kill the Cyber Demon. Maybe not this game. Maybe they weren't quite that mean yet. But that's definitely something that like Final Doom would do. Final Doom is just out to be an asshole to you. Alright, that will do it for episode 6, and we get a traditional exit sign, which is, I feel like that's a weird thing for them to have in hell, but it's nice to see a familiar face, sort of. Maybe that means it's a trap. Nope, it's not a trap. I fought against the Cyber Demon wickedly, or the Cyber Demon fought against me wickedly. And hell followed. I have a full complement of cell ammo now, which is nice. Did I ever get that BFG? I don't remember, but if I didn't, I already had one, so I am equipped for any contingency. I don't remember this level very well. I reckon I will start remembering this level in a hurry. Yellow key? I'm just gonna go ahead and drop a mark on my map for that. If I can... There we go. Wait, that's not very big. Well, it looks bigger when you zoom out. It's weird that the mark doesn't scale with everything else. Just so I remember that there's a key there for later if I want to save. Or if I need to save. Well, this looks ominous. Okay. I'm surprised that it let me escape that. This game is messing with my head. This thing in the middle doesn't even teleport me. That's nothing. I don't know where these monsters are teleporting to. I see them teleporting. Ow. Yeah. I think the worst thing about Lost Souls is their tendency to charge you right before you fire a rocket and blow yourself up. I mean, you blow them up too. You blow them up pretty well. My cup of rockets runneth over at the moment, so I'm trying to make use of them and conserve some of my more versatile ammo. Well, I guess I'm almost full on shotgun shells as well. Oh my god, this game. Thanks, buddy. It'd be really funny if after all this, there wasn't even anything bad on this level. It just makes me jump out of my skin repeatedly, and then there's not even like a baron of hell. Just all of this on... Well, that's a thing. It's not quite what I was expecting, but... It's not nothing. I think I'll leave that yellow key there for now. Because if I get it now, then that means I'll have a save immediately after my previous one. Damn it, I was hoping I could one-shot both of them with a shotgun, but I should have gone for the shotgun guy first. Okay, so can I just run past this crusher? Yes. Oh, back here. Really? I haven't been on that teleporter pad yet. Hello. Ah, damn it. It's been pretty nice so far about letting me back out of and run away from situations instead of trapping me in rooms with stuff, which makes me even more suspicious. What does this do? It's a momentary switch. There's something behind this BFG. Oh. Oh. Damn it, I should have just grabbed the invulnerability sphere. I got spooked. I mean, clearly it wants me to grab the invincibility and BFG the Cyber Demon. So, you know, I should be nice and at least try to give it what it wants. Okay, that was not too bad. Man, the Cyber Demon just has so much health. I always expect even the BFG to not be that effective. I can grab that key now. Or I feel okay about grabbing the key now that I accomplished something else. You know, good health, good armor, good ammo. Kill the Cyber Demon. Of course, I should pay attention to what color the doors actually are, so I have a better idea of where to go next. This is open when it hasn't been open before, so this is probably where I want to go. Or at least this general direction. Crud. That sounded close. You want to open the door or you want to make me do it? Does it not even tell you what color key you need? Like, this is a red door. It's showing up as red on the map. But nothing about it indicates that you need the red key here. That seems kind of broken. Ah. I'm being a little careful about this door because this seems like the kind of door that would lock me out, potentially. Because the enemies weren't able to open the door, and it's showing up as like a double-walled door on the map. So this might be a door. Well, I bet what it is you're meant to approach it from the other side. So, having the right key. No, it's not even, like, obviously red from this side either. Weird. Sequence breaking things a little bit with the starting with every color key. I mean, it makes it easier, of course, because you can go anywhere, but it also makes it a bit more of a challenge to figure out what to do if you're not paying close attention, because it directs you with the order in which you get the keys. Of course, the real answer is, since I do have the keys, there's not necessarily a right order to do anything, but some levels, you know, they have triggers that are not related to the keys in the colored doors, and by not getting the keys in the right order, sometimes those triggers can get a little confusing. Alright, so after I clear this area out, I'm gonna wanna grab that radiation suit. And then looks like there's a passage on both sides here. Also, there's two radiation suits. Definitely want to remember this place when I'm low on health. Sucks how sometimes you get hit immediately after stepping on the acid. Like, usually there's a little bit of a grace period of a couple seconds. So you can step off and grab the radiation suit. Like, if you fall on the radiation suit. Oh no. If you fall on the radiation suit, you can get it without taking damage. This is bad. Okay, well. Oh, the Keymaster can't follow me out here now. Hopefully it just stays up there. Leaves me alone. It doesn't try to come after me at this point. It would have a hard time finding me. Alright, let's grab the other radiation suit and continue exploring this way. Some of the Mars base architecture starting to bleed in. Bleed into hell. It's like the opposite of episode 3. Instead of hell bleeding into space, space is bleeding in here. It's interesting. And I guess they kind of foreshadowed that a little bit with the earthly exit sign. I'm not 100% sure where episode 4 fits in with everything, like, lore-wise. If I understand correctly, it's sort of an interstitial episode between Doom 1 and Doom 2. Which means you would still be in hell at that point. Well, no, because at the end of episode 3, you're back on Earth, and you see the Earth's, you know, you see the beginning of the invasion. Of hell. This is troubling. I should really figure out where this arrow is before I get myself in more trouble. Or try to figure out where it is. I'm worried that it has something to do with a secret that I'm not finding. Which is often a problem for me. Okay. Oh, okay. Well, I'm glad I thought to check that. I wonder what's supposed to be there. Okay, well, that is a bit of a relief. So now I can make my way back out into the hell area, get my BFG ready just in case. Well, kill this thing first. So I don't have to deal with it later. Get my BFG ready. That's the end. Well, golly. I was really expecting a surprise. Alright. Unto the cruel. Interesting. I don't know why I BFG'd that imp. That was totally unnecessary. So this is episode 8. This is the last level, but it didn't give me the message. Like, this is still a Keymaster level. So this level must have a traditional exit switch or teleporter, unlike the 8th level of the previous episodes. And again, I don't remember much about this level. Like, I don't remember much about episode 4 in general, so I don't know what to expect. The Keymaster is a shotgun guy, which, okay, could be worse. Yeah, I know. Hi. Wait, is it a shotgun guy or is it a zombie man? No, it's... Oh, yes. Yes, fight each other. Kill that Keymaster, Baron. You don't have to take its shit. You're the master around here, not that dork. Yes, fight each other. Excellent. Nope, not me. I'm nobody. Don't worry about me. Just a quiet little mouse. Of course, it's going to take him just as long to kill the Baron as it would take me with the shotgun, because he's not doing extra damage or anything. It actually takes him longer than it would take me, because the shotgun guy, even though he can shoot faster than a normal shotgun guy, you know, he's still not as fast. Well, he might be about as fast with the shotgun as I am. You weren't expecting an invincible shotgun guy, were you? I think they noticed me, or at least the shotgun guy did. I think he took a couple shots at me there. I'm fully expecting there to be another Baron of Hell in here, and I was right. Hopefully the shotgun guy will take care of the Baron on the other side, and I can take care of this one from a safe distance. If I can aim my damn rocket launcher. Okay. Okay, sure. I'll take an autosave there. Or a save. Okay, well, I'm away from the Keymaster. So that's a boon. I chose a very creepy track for this level, similar to how I chose a very creepy one for E3 M8. Although, this is more of an energetic final level than episodes 2 and 3 had. Like, episode 1 kind of had a lot going on, even though it ultimately wasn't that difficult. There was a lot of stuff, there were a lot of specters, so it felt like a more action-packed level. So I chose a really high energy track for that one. Okay, good. This is not death hell water. Oh, these just lower for me? I don't have to run across them? I don't have to sprint across them like this was some kind of dang platformer? That is very nice of this game to do that for me. I very much appreciate it. Don't know why it gave me light amplification goggles, but I'll take it, I guess. Oh, there's a soul sphere. Wow, that one just lowers for me too. I'm not used to this game being so nice. Makes me think it's about to not be so nice anymore. No? I was expecting a cyber demon to pop out or something when I grabbed the armor. Is this level called Unto the Cruel? So far, I have to say it's been the opposite of cruel. Well, not the opposite. It's had an absence of cruelty. I guess it's been kind. Like, the way it gave me 200 health and armor for essentially free, that was very kind of it. I know, I'm not supposed to be able to look down. But, you know, screw that. I have a neck, and I know how to use it, dang it. I don't know, there's a stereotype of Marines and, you know, military people, or I guess beefy action heroes in general, having a thick neck, like, that's a thing that goes along with bodybuilding, apparently. I've never heard of it making it harder for them to look down. I mean, I guess if you're buff and fit, it would theoretically be easier to bend at the waist, so you don't have to bend your neck. I was gonna say maybe not being able to look down. They were like simulating the buff bodybuilding action hero with such a Rubenesque neck that, you know, he just can't look down into the elevator shaft. I don't think Rubenesque is the word I'm looking for, but I can't think of the right word right now. I have Barons of Hell to deal with. Rubenesque just means like plump, I think. Which, I mean, it's a plump neck. But the connotation is a little different. Sure, I'll walk through the teleporter. I'm back out with the Keymaster, I think. I don't know, I guess I'm thinking about buff action heroes a lot because I just play Contra. Another soul sphere? This level is being kind to me. I don't want to get it yet, of course, but I will make a note of it for future reference. Let's give the plasma gun some love. Right, I wasn't actually able to flip those switches because I was immediately baroned. Oh, Spider Mastermind. Well, I guess it is a level 8, so it makes sense that I would start seeing that stuff. Kind of sucks that the Keymaster is going to be taking pot shots at me the entire time I deal with this. Oh, I got it. And I see the arrow. I think. I thought I saw the arrow. I saw something blue, and I thought it was sparkly. That's the exit. I do remember the exit to this level just being a big hole in the floor. Oh yeah, that is totally the arrow up there. Must be behind a secret wall or something, or a secret door. Try approaching it from the other direction. Once again, it just gives me the stuff for free. It is being very kind, all things considered. Oh, okay. I just had to approach it from the other direction. That's all. So I guess the quote-unquote boss of episode 4 is just another spider mastermind. Maybe they're trying to make up for episode 3 with it not being much of a boss, or kind of an anticlimactic one. Which, people complain about that, about the boss of episode 3 being an anticlimax. I see it as being a reward, you know? You saved up, you found the BFG, first of all, which, that's not an easy thing to do. Like, I don't think that they just give you one for free. You saved the ammo, you know, you made it there with the full arsenal. And you are showing hell how much of a badass you are. And I think that's beautiful. I think killing the Spider Mastermind in 3 hits is a satisfying ending, because it's like, oh, thank God it doesn't make me do a bunch of bullshit. I can just finish the game. So, you know, I'm okay with it. But of course, you know, I have a very different perspective not playing it in 1993. Maybe if I had, you know, downloaded the shareware version, gotten super hype about it, bought the game for $60, $50 or $60 or whatever it was, maybe I would have been a little bit more let down. But you know, my perspective is not even having played episode 3 until years later, because it wasn't in the version that I had. But here it gives you a nice proper ending level with the proper-ish boss fight, I guess. It still wasn't super difficult, but this will finish up the original Doom. Spider Mastermind must have sent forth its legions of Hellspawn, and it is filling up my screen right now. God, my eyes. Before your final confrontation with that terrible beast from hell. But you stepped forward and brought forth eternal damnation and suffering upon the Horde as a true hero would in the face of something so evil. Besides, someone was going to pay for what happened to Daisy, your pet rabbit. Right, the rabbit. So, remember, the rabbit thing would have been 2 years ago at this point, because Ultimate Doom came out in 1995, which is after Doom 2. So for people who played through the original Doom and went on to Doom 2, I don't think it addresses the rabbit stuff at all in Doom 2. Like, it kind of doesn't have any story. Like, it doesn't have these, from what I remember, Doom 2 doesn't have this text. It's just like 30 straight levels. So I guess it's like addressing slash calling back to the thing with the rabbit, because that was really confusing. I don't know. Maybe it mentioned it in the manual somewhere. But now you see spread before you more potential pain, and wow, gibitude. They were actually using the word jibs at this point, and like, I thought it was just a fan thing that happened, like, not necessarily even at the same time. I didn't know they were using jibs internally at id. Gibitude as a nation of demons run amok. A nation of demons run, that not proper subject verb agreement there, should be a nation runs amok among our cities. Next up, Hell on Earth, which if you were playing this when it came out, you probably already played Hell on Earth, but that's cool, I guess. Oh, and look at you. Still carrying around that rabbit head. I guess. That's cool. But yeah. That will do it. For Doom. I don't know what I'm going to do after this. I don't think I'll move directly on to Doom 2. I think I will take a break, do something else. Do something a little more chill, maybe. I'll probably finish up Contra, because I came so close to clearing it on One to Continue. If you haven't watched that yet, you can go back and check that out. I had an alarm set for an hour here, but I didn't need it. So yeah, that will do it for Doom Keymaster Mod Edition. Thank you all for watching. Sorry these past couple episodes were a little bit more frustrating, but it was an interesting challenge. I hope I found a good balance of auto-saving with the key stuff. And I hope it was entertaining. I hope this setup continues to be entertaining if I play Doom in the future. Shout me out in the comments if you want to see more Doom in the future. Shout me out if you thought this sucked and you don't want to see this anymore, or you want a different mod, you know? Let me know what you want to see. And I can't promise, I can't make any promises, but I will take it into consideration. I had a lot of fun playing this, you know, Doom, just as fun to play through now as it was back then with the Keymaster mod. Puts a new interesting twist on it, and I'm sure I will enjoy the rest of it as well. Either on camera or off camera. But for now, I will say goodbye. Goodbye.